Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nicher, a retired lecturer in Mortality Preaching Christianity, and let's summarize what we have said. So the royal kings are Sachae Paatshah, the people who do not mend their ways through preaching his word. Such satanic people are dealt by the sole power of Sachae Paatshahs, royal kings. There were four in the east, the epicenter of satanic people being Amritsar or the Punjab, and none in the Middle East, as word of mouth was enough for Judas Iscariot to kill himself. There is none above Sachae Paatshah, and Sachae Paatshah Gobind Singh Ji was the last of the four prophets. There two came in the Middle East, John the Baptist, Prophet Elijah, or an ideal rabbi, and Christ Jesus. And two came in the East, which were Christ or Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, who took six forms to preach gospel, and over 150 years. And then we had four royal kings to sort out the satanic people with sword power, because we in India had kings and emperors of darkness. And there shall be none after him. There shall be none after Sachae Paatshah Gobind Singh Ji. He was the last prophet of the series of the four. To address Satguru Nanak Dev Ji as Guru is degrading. And to address Sachae Paatshah royal kings as gurus is highly degrading. So people who do so, they have no knowledge of Sikhism. They have been brainwashed. Such people are spiritually blind, and sometimes they turn fanatics. So the other thing, as we said, you know, that in the previous ages, we used to have the rabbis or the Brahmins, and they were the moral teachers working for Adam. As Adam is flesh, so they were also in flesh. And they were called gurus. The word gur in India means the formula to solve a problem. As you have, you know, in chemistry, physics, you apply formulas, you know, to solve the solution, to solve the problems, or to work out the chemical formulas and other things. Same, you know, this gur means formula. So those Brahman Guru, they were giving the gur about Adam, moral laws. They were the gurus of the moral laws. Whereas in God is spirit, and his priest, they are called Christ or Satgurus. In this one, so the God is the Gur. He is our formula that we should apply. And what is his formula? To do his will, not your own. His will is neutral, is impartial, it is righteous. Anybody who is a righteous person, he is doing the will of our Father. Anybody who is unrighteous, he is doing the will of the Satan. So injustices in society and all those, you know, they are all originate from Satan. That they cause problem, wars. That is why people are fed up, you know. They say religion creates war. Religion does not create wars. And if you go by your own judgment, in which you treat others as you wish to be treated. That is the formula of our Father God. You can't go wrong. You can't then blame religion creating wars. But when these people, as I have stated earlier, such as the Pope and other people, they come between man and God, they start dictating their own wills, and the people are turned fanatics, then they create war and unrest. It's all due to mammon and self-centered praises. So if people are impartial and unbiased, seeking only the praises of our Father, not their own praises, and they are like little children who are impartial and who have no hatred for any. So if you become like little children, then only you enter into the royal kingdom of God, which is within your heart. And then Christ is the one who is leading your life, not you. Christ is impartial, righteous person. So then you will behave righteously and impartially. And when you do so, then justice will prevail in society. Justice will bring peace, and peace is called heaven. So that's what the rabbi used to do when they were impartial, they were not greedy, they were bringing peace into society. But as they became greedy, and then the emphasis shifts from the rabbis to God is our guru. So we receive our gur, our formulas for peace of mind, from our Father. And our Father is impartial, righteous person, like Abraham was a righteous person. So it is not so easy in this dark age when mammon is also powerful, and that can dissuade you from righteousness. Take for example the war in Iraq. So the people were made to believe that Saddam Hussein has the weapons of mass destruction. The inspectors went there and they found none, you know. But still, because the mammon is strong, mammon makes the mere go. So United States and United Kingdom, UK, they attacked Iraq. And after attacking Iraq, which was unrighteous thing to do, because he had no weapons of mass destruction, look at that, what they have done to Iraq. That is the work of the Satan. It is not the work of the sons of man. So they are suffering, and these things are all happening according to the will of our Father. So end of the age is approaching, and such things will happen. So that will create right atmosphere for the atomic war to occur, when the unrighteousness will far exceed the righteousness, as it was in the Sodom and Gomorrah, or before the destruction of the temple. All the people were cheat and unrighteous, that temple had to be destroyed, So this world would be destroyed by atomic weapons.